heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? But watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away somehow. One step closer. I have died every day waiting for you, darling. Don't love you for a thousand more. Time stands still, beauty and all she is. I will be brave, I will not let anything take away what's standing in front of me. Every breath, every hour has come to this. One step closer. I have died every day waiting for you, darling. Don't I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more. And all along I believed I would find you. Time has brought your heart to me. I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a died every day waiting for you, darling. Don't be afraid. I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more.
Oh, I'm obsessed. Oh, I'm obsessed with the way your head is laying on my chest. How you love the things I hate about myself that no one knows. But with you, I see hope again. Oh, I'm a mess when I overthink the little things in my head. You seem to always help me catch my breath, but then I lose it again. When I look at you, that's the end. And why do I get so nervous when I look into...
Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
I just want us to take a moment to thank God for bringing this couple together. The word God has for them began a year ago, for it was His hand over their lives that helped them jump the gun and make sure Rachel stayed healthy. It truly is because of the Lord that Rachel is able to stand here today. Hello, I am Alex McDonald, and I am extremely honored to be able to welcome you all here today to celebrate two wonderful people and Brutus, two of my best friends coming together for the second time to show their love for each other here before all of you, the people who mean the most to them. I first heard about Rachel before I actually met her. I heard that she and Cameron had started dating, and I was very excited to meet her, have a new person in the friend group, and hey, maybe there's a chance that whoever this new person is, maybe there's a chance that I'm gonna be more fit than them. I then met Rachel, and that thought was very quickly proven wrong. Rachel then proceeded to beat me in every workout that we've ever done, and I don't think it's gonna change. But her fitness level doesn't even begin to describe her. The kindness that she has always shown is what stands out to me more than anything. There have been so many conversations with Rachel and myself, Rachel and friends, Rachel and strangers, and she always helps them. She would take her time away from her own workouts just to watch someone's video to help them improve, whether it was her practical tips or just words of encouragement. Rachel was there for everyone. That's who she is, and it's beautiful. First time I met Cameron, you guys are never gonna guess where we met. It was at a CrossFit gym. You probably did guess that. But a few of us were new to the gym, and Cameron is one of the first people who came over, introduced himself, and came and hung out with us, which is probably a similar first experience that a lot of you have had with Cameron. He's the one that will break the ice. He is the one who will make everyone feel comfortable. And it's only fair that I mention Cameron also beat me in every single workout that we've ever done together. Working out with this couple has been great for my self-esteem. Very early in our friendship, Cam and I realized that we have a shockingly similar sense of humor. And I knew we were gonna be friends, great friends, right away. Cameron has this innate ability to cheer everyone up and make them laugh. All of you know this. It's very apparent as to what kind of guy you're getting with Cameron. It's exclusively great things. All of that, Cameron, is why you are top two of people who are getting married today. That's pretty good. When Cameron and Rachel started dating, it was an instant fit. I've thought a lot over the past few weeks about when I first saw them together, and the term I keep coming back to is unsurprising. It's not the most glamorous word, and sometimes it even has a negative connotation. But today I mean it in the most positive and romantic way possible. I mean it in the way of when I first saw them together, I simply thought, yep, these two belong together. There was no will they, won't they, there was no question, there was no fighting. It was unsurprising. There was just love and an extreme feeling that they had each found their person. And it's been so much fun being able to be around that for the past few years. I want to take a quick moment to talk about the importance of love and how to best navigate that path in life. And I think my friend group would agree that I am the best person to talk about this topic. There have always been and always will be ups and downs, but your passion for each other has kept you together. There have been no question that you two would end up here. When we think of one of you, we think of the other. All of today and this ceremony are great, but it only begins to capture the essence of how special your relationship is. A quote that symbolizes you both comes from a great philosopher. Taylor Swift once said, "I like shiny things, but I'd marry you with paper rings." Many people will give you advice and tips how to love and to be married, but your love is what you two make it. There is no right way. There is no wrong way. It's simply the Cameron and Rachel way. Every single moment and decision of your intertwined lives have led you to this, standing up here, staring into each other's eyes, and occasionally mine, but deep with love. This isn't about just surviving. It's about thriving. This is about making your spouse a better person for each other, for your family, and for God. It's about your own individual growth, but with the best possible support person that you could ever have. And I know you two feel the same way about each other. So whatever life may throw at you, just go with it, with the same passion and vigor that you guys have for each other. And don't forget to do it the Cameron and Rachel way. The couple has decided to write their own vows and share them. So Rachel, you will go first.
Okay. Thank you. Oh, I gotta unlock it, because I'm super cool. Okay. Okay. Try not to cry. Okay, I'm just gonna look down so I don't cry. I know we already been married a year, but this year together has been wonderful, Cameron. In the book of Song of Solomon, it says, I have found the one whom my soul loves. And it's true. To the inner depths of my being, I love you. A love that's not my own, but given to me as a gift. A gift that I'm so thankful for. Cameron, I also want to state that your worth is far more than the insurance plan that you provide for me. But that I am very thankful for. Without your willing heart to marry me sooner than expected, I might not be here before you today. to be your wife. You said, you can't leave me, that's the rule. You're stuck. So I am very thankful to celebrate this moment together. So Cameron, you are everything when you're everything I need when I need it. You don't hesitate to help me, love me, support me. When I got into chiropractic school far away from home, you didn't say, do you have to go? You said, when are we going? You believe in my dreams, whatever the ambition is. You've always been there for me, present in my solid ground. You are everything that I've hoped I wanted. Last year was really scary. There were many moments I was very afraid because no one ever wants to hear the word cancer. And I didn't think I would make it sometimes. But you were there for me and you kept me strong. You filled me with hope and joy. And you just were everything that a marriage should represent, which is love. You filled my world with love, cherished happy moments, and you loved me so much. You never let a day go by without telling me how much that you love me or how much I mean to you. You say it daily, and I am so thankful for that. I don't have to earn it. Ever. You just give it unconditionally. I can open up and be vulnerable with you. You make me feel worthy and show me that I am worth far more than anything of this world. When I'm sad or angry or stressed with school, you're always there for me. Cameron, you fill up my cup and loving you is easy. So I promise to live this life with you and to love you always. I'm skipping ahead sometimes, okay. I promise to live this life with you, with our many dogs, through the up and downs of life that, through all that, I pray that I can rely on you as much as you can rely on me. I vow to work hard in school to make this adventure worthwhile. I promise to always be sassy, no matter what. I promise to always give you a face when your common response to many things is I don't make the rules. No matter what I ask you, it's I don't make the rules. when you say that I couldn't roll my eyes farther back into my head, no matter what, even if I'm mad or sad, I just always see you and I just always love you. And I always just remember how cute you are. So you have given me a life I thought I never would have. I promise to love you, cherish you, and I will always love your face too. I promise to never let you go or to never leave you, because that's the rule, we're stuck. I love you, you are my best friend and you're my partner in life. And I'm thankful for all that you are and continue to be. Thank you for being the person that I needed, my best friend. So to finish this, Cameron, you totally rock.
You bring your water, did you? Nope, perfect. Yep. All good. So, Rachel, as I woke up this morning and you left for the gym, I prepared to write these vows.
Good, I'm so glad.
For the second time on the day of. I couldn't help but think about how unique it is to do this after a full year of marriage. Like you said, we've had a year ripe with change, a new city away from our family and friends, yourself being wrapped up in school, finding new gyms, making new friends who have become like family, multiple surgeries, and about a dozen other things I'm certain to leave out. But looking back now, in spite of all the struggles, it was all easy because I had you. You are my constant in life, and you got me, you got it. Sorry, Stephen. And I know that no matter how my day goes, I still get to come home to you and Brutus and whatever trash or Tupperware he decided to eat that day.
Yeah.
And I know that whatever those struggles were, that we'll figure it out and get through it together. As cliche as these things are, you really are my best friend. And I can say for a fact that I love you even more today than I did last April when we did this for the first time. And I'd wager I'll be saying that same statement many, many more times before it's all over. And while I'm no cat, and I can't promise you pizza sundaes forever, and I can't promise you 5 dogs, 3 chickens, 2 cats, and a goat, I can promise you a few things. I can promise to continue to give you the constant love and hugs and kisses when you've had a bad day, especially when you refuse to accept them. And that same amount of attention when you're trying to study and need me to leave you alone. I promise to continue to be sarcastic and make you laugh at any possible time, even when it is the absolute worst time for that. In short, I promise to continue to be the man you married a year ago and continue to grow to become the man you deserve, regardless of whatever twists and turns come in the next year and years and decades. I promise to be the same constant loving presence that you've been for me. I love you, and I love your face, and I love your butt.
And now, just to make sure that we're all in agreement here, Rachel. Do you, Rachel, take Cameron to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Do you, Cameron, take Rachel to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do. Again.
That is great, because it would be a bit late if you guys said anything other than that. Now for the ring exchange. The rings, please. Cameron, place Rachel's ring on her finger and repeat after me. I, Cameron Williams, give you this ring as a token of my love.
I, Cameron Williams, give you this ring as a token of my love.
I offer you all that I have.
I offer you all that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I ever will be.
And all that I ever will be.
Rachel, please place Cameron's ring on his finger and repeat after me. I, Rachel Blong.
I, Rachel Blong.
Give you this ring.
Give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
I offer you all that I have.
I offer you all that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I ever will be.
All that I ever will be.
Today, Cameron and Rachel have chosen to braid 3 strands. Together into a single cord. Each strand has a significant meaning. The middle white strand representing God. The strand to the right of the cross represents the groom and his life, while the strand to the left of the cross represents the bride and her life. In braiding these 3 strands together, Cameron and Rachel are demonstrating that their marriage is more than a joining of 2 lives together. It is a unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect off it. As Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12 reads, "Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken." And now, by the power vested in me by you two, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce, for the second time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Williams.
But I ain't got much to show, so I'm asking you to show me some forgiveness. It's all for you in my pursuit of happiness. Chasing that life, moving on, cause I had to prove there ain't no life worth doing what I did to you. So I'm asking you to show me some forgiveness.
If everybody would like to bow their head, I'll bless the food and bless the meal. Dear Lord, thank you for the rain holding out. That's the first thing. So we got through the pictures and everything else today and the ceremony. Really, really appreciate that, Lord. Lord, we thank you for all the gathering of friends and family. Really appreciate it. And Lord, we just ask that you bless this meal and bless this time together. We're going to be dancing inside tonight instead of outside, but we really appreciate what you've done for us to have this beautiful ceremony with probably the best vows I think I've ever heard myself. So great job, Cameron and Rachel. And so please enjoy the wedding and please enjoy the food. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Amen. We're a little out of order, but when you have CrossFit bridegrooms and bridesmaids, protein packing is the priority. So we had to get that out of the way and go from there, and we could start with the ceremony. So myself and Ken will do a couple of toasts, and then we have a host of people, including my daughter, you know, giving a couple of other toasts. So we have quite the lineup here coming, but anyway, again, really happy to have everybody here. Welcome again. We really appreciate everybody coming. And if you don't know me, I'm Rachel's dad, first name Rich, last name Blong. Again, Cameron will be up here in a minute, but we really appreciate everybody coming. And I have a lot of thank yous to do. That's my part here today. And I'd also be remiss if I didn't introduce and wish all the moms here a happy Mother's Day. So happy Mother's Day to all the moms. Indeed, there are no weddings without these moms, so thank you very much. Got to give them their due. Also, our son Matt is graduating from UNC Chapel Hill tomorrow. Mary and I will be there. So we have commencements in the morning. We appreciate him as well. And certainly Mary and I, as well as Ken and Sherry, Cameron's parents, who are back there and they'll be up in a minute. You know, have a lot of people to thank. We want to thank everybody for coming locally as well as from afar. We got some out-of-state people and we really appreciate everybody coming. Really nice job. We also want to thank the 1932 Barnum staff. I mean, this is a great facility, great job by them. We also want to thank our officiant, Alex. Alex, you were like awesome today up there. We certainly want to thank the family catering service. Bill Clemens, our DJ, who's outside, and he'll get that started in a few minutes. We got Adrian, the awesome videographer. We certainly have also Tina and Janice, the hair and makeup geniuses. They're awesome. Great job with everybody. Very nice, very nice. We have Johnny Andrus, a family friend, who is the local photographer from upstate New York. And Johnny is actually getting married in September to his girlfriend, Jill. So we'll see you in September, that's for sure. So, you know, very, Very nice. A lot of hard work into a wedding, so we appreciate everybody. I'd like to thank my wife, Mary, who's worked with the 1932 barn. Cameron and Rachel from a distance. It's not easy coordinating a wedding between Charlotte and St. Louis, but we pulled it off. So thank you, Mary, for your hard efforts, as well as Cher and everybody else involved. Thank you very much. I think it's important to thank Sherry and Ken, as well as Mary Jo back there, for probably the best rehearsal lunch I've ever seen in my life. Very nice. I don't know if everybody knows this, but we went over to the Charlotte Speedway, had a tour, got to run the track. I think the highlight of the day was my brother driving my mother up on that 24 angle bank at high speed. So that was kind of cool, and she did survive. If you're looking for Rachel posted on Instagram. So if you want the experience from the rider's view, it's out there somewhere. I saw it this morning. So pretty cool. Sherry and Ken also hosted the bridal shower before Christmas, and so we appreciate you doing that very much. Thank you. Thank you very much for that. I got a couple more. Sorry. Also, on behalf of the couple and the parents, we want to thank everybody for the bridal shower gifts, as well as the gifts today. They're much appreciated for those just getting started in life. So thank you very much. This is also, if you guys got a glimpse when we did the wedding ceremony, this is not a unique wedding anymore where couples have two dates. It's pretty common since 2020. A lot of couples had to get married in a small ceremony. Like Cameron and Rachel, they got married in St. Louis at a CrossFit gym a little over a year ago. So we're glad they did that. And we have the official wedding today, May 7th, 2022. So we really appreciate that. So I guess I'd like to officially say, happy anniversary, 1 year. But I think the best thing is we're finally glad to get to celebrate the wedding with all your family and friends. So thank you very much. And on the matter of two dates, Cameron, this is for you now. I got some advice coming now. On the matter of two dates, for all the spouses out there, a lot of spouses got to manage a couple of dates, you specifically. But for the husband, missing dates or forgetting dates is not a good thing. So my first advice, probably my only advice, I might have a few more things, is just don't forget any dates. It's crucial. I'd also like to say, don't forget to help around the house. Very important. Have a regular date night. Tell her she looks great, even in her worst moments. That's probably the most important one. Communicate to her when whatever's going on. Just keep communicating. And my favorite of all time is she asks for Robitussin, go get it. I made that mistake once, really bad. I didn't get it. All right. So officially, I'd like to welcome both Cameron and Rachel to your extended families. Families are certainly unique and awesome. They're great, but we all have different ways of showing we love you. We do it in different ways. So here's the deal. You be patient with us, and we'll be patient with you. All right. On the matter of both of you, we're all very glad you found each other, and people are asking me how you met, so that's where this comes in, Betty. Anyway, you're an awesome couple, and it started, I don't know, a few years ago now, where a friend, Kenzie, recommended that you go ahead and check each other's Instagram account out, right? You got to go check that Instagram account out and see if they, well, is he okay? Oh, he's cute, and vice versa. But thank you, Kenzie. They are a perfect match, and we really appreciate it. All right, you guys have lots in common. CrossFit, you guys are CrossFitter. Rachel is still competing, you can tell with some of the bridesmaids, as well as Cameron is a regular coach, week in and week out with CrossFit. You guys love sports, you both love to hike and be outdoors, and you share a love of dogs. Brody is here. So, you know, you have a lot in common, but here's my advice to you. But the advice I leave you both with today is it your differences that ultimately be your glue. And that's not apparent when you start out. Guys are kind of, we don't get it all the time. So the differences can cause some trouble in the beginning. When couples realize that their differences are also their strengths, especially when... especially when life's challenges come your way, that's when you realize that your strengths will carry the day. Through work, through school, and maybe even a couple of children in the future. Hopefully.
No pressure.
No pressure. All right, so beside enjoying your common interests, pay special attention to your differences and learn to encourage each other and their differences. Certainly from the vows, I think you guys are off to a great start. A couple's differences can often lead to friction in a marriage, especially early on. Exhibit A. But God, you know, God has them there because once you're married, He sees you as one to the other, as Alex certainly talked about this afternoon. So learn to love and respect these differences. Some need more love, some need more respect. But they both go hand in hand. So figure it out and be mindful of what the other part needs on any given day, and then go from there. So with all that said, I would ask that everyone raise their glasses, and we finally get to officially welcome Mr. and Mrs. Cameron and Rachel Blom. I mean, Williams. Cameron and Rachel Williams, sorry. You got that on film. And with that, I will bring up Cameron's dad, Ken, who's done an awesome job yesterday with his wife, Sherry and Mary Jo.
Well, thank you all for attending, and thank you to the Bloms for putting on quite a thing today. And I don't have quite as much to say. He did such a great job with all the thanks. I just want to tell you guys that, you know, what you don't know now is when you, you know, as a parent, when you become a parent, what you do is your kids. That's what we do. We've done it for years. The parents completely understand what that means. You guys may have a sense of it, and I hope that one day that you will have a full sense. But your sorrows are more than they seem to be, but your triumphs and your love is just exponentially greater. And for you two to be so happy, to be so in love, to have your match, makes this one of the most joyous days that Sherry and I have ever experienced. And we just are thrilled to have Rachel within our family as well as the extended Blong family. And we just wish you the best. Cheers to you.
I'm Sydney, Rachel's sister. So Rachel and Cameron. I just want to start off by saying I'm super glad that you two found each other. I remember when Rachel came home, one of the very first times after she found you, talking about this great guy she saw for the first time at a CrossFit gym. And I was very skeptical because she had not too recently gotten out of not a great relationship breakup, so I was naturally skeptical. But as the time grew on or went on, they started to form their relationship, and I knew as soon as I met Cameron that this one stuck. This one was going to stay. So I just wanted to say thank you, Cameron, for coming into Rachel's life and being that partner for her that she needs and that will stick. And I just wish you guys the best. So cheers.
All right. Oh, she looks so cute. Yeah. I've known Rachel for about 23 years. We go way back. I just want to start out with just saying that I remember growing up, my mom, our mom, always said that Rachel, when I was just a wee toddler, a wee babe, was the most nurturing, protective, caring sister. Well, that's what I was told. when I became more self-aware, didn't really add up. Yeah. There's some discrepancies there. Just a little bit. But yeah, things got better, I guess. When we moved down to Charlotte, we took our dad, took our whole family. You know, we went down to Charlotte, and that's kind of when our relationship started to meld together, when we started to bond. She would drive me to school. We went to the same Christian private school, endured the same traumas that included. Yeah. But through it all, we became closer. We became our... I was always the shoulder to cry on whenever she was going through a bad breakup or someone was being annoying, and just, it is what it is. But I just wanted to say that, and Rachel kind of recently is kind of my experience coming out and all of these things. You've been so supportive of my journey, and you've been a sister that has had my back through and through, regardless of the circumstances, regardless of how I felt about myself. And you've always been there for me when I was taking time off of school, and I was always there for you during your hardships and whatever you were going through. And so I just want to say thank you for that. Thank you for being the best sister. Sydney, also, you're great. Yeah. The two best sisters that I could ask for. And I just kind of want to end my toast with some words by the great Friedrich Nietzsche. Become what you are. And I'm so glad that you have someone by your side that can help you realize that. And I hope that you find the path that you're on, this new era of becoming the woman, the person, the athlete, the soon-to-be doctor that you are. And you're gonna wear, I know, congrats. I know you're gonna wear that well, and I just hope for all the best. I love you.
Then you look super scared.
I'm scared.
All right, Cameron, I've always loved you since the first time we saw each other. You are my special golden... Oh, shit. These are my vows in case someone had to step up to the plate. My bad. But yeah, Cameron, you don't know how long I've been waiting for this moment to tell all your family and friends about everything I know. Ladies and gentlemen, we are surely in for a treat. But in all honesty, my name is Eric Ewald. I've been in a bromance with Cameron for over 15 years. If you don't know what a bromance is, it's when two straight guys say I love to each other, but they're completely sober. So Cameron actually was my first friend when I moved down to North Carolina from Minnesota about 15 years ago. And I know not many of you know me personally or Cameron and I's relationship, but after 15 years, I truly don't know who's dumber, me or you for being friends with me for 15 years. And you'd think that you could get two decently smart gentlemen together, we could do great things. But instead, we took the fairly odd parents route. If you don't know the quote, it's two halves of a whole idiot. But, you know, even if you don't believe that, you can always ask your parents, actually, our parents. They'll have plenty of stories to tell. But, you know, I think I would actually take this time and for once in my life, try to surprise you and try to be nice. Try. No promises. But Cameron, you've always been the most supportive man I know. Through the countless FIFA games, the raging parties, one in particular we won't talk about. Rachel, you can explain more later. Through the countless girlfriends, Sam, wherever you're at, sorry, wish I met you years ago. Through the Dark Knight experience, the habanero pepper experiment, and lastly, the pepper spray. You know, now that I think of it, you've caused me a lot of pain in my life. But, you know, at the end of the day, what are best friends for? You know, they're there for you through the pain, the trials and tribulations, the thousands of misspelled text messages. You've always been the Ron Weasley to my Harry Potter. And I guess that's what's meant to have a best friend. There's very few people in the world that are stronger than Cameron. But somehow, by a miracle, you found Rachel, who, let me remind you, can literally beat you up in any split second. So don't mess up. But, you know, strength doesn't always have to mean physical strength, right? You know, she's stronger in the way that she approaches you. You know, a partner needs to push you to be a better version of yourself, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, and for you guys, physically. But, you know, you need to strive for greatness and be there when times are tough. And Rachel, oh, Rachel. Cameron and I always joked about we were the ones that decided who married each other, not the parents. And I can proudly say, you met and ultimately exceeded all my expectations. The fact that you can handle us together is honestly mind-blowing. And even more, I'm glad you finally agreed to the idea of a group marriage, the joint house, our kids going to Clemson, and our kids getting married. But please do remember, Rachel, I called dibs 15 years ago, and you have to share. Okay. But ultimately, can we all please raise our glass to the bride and groom? I love you guys.
I'm Cameron's brother. Some of you might not have known that because apparently he didn't tell people he had a brother at the gym. But no, seriously, on Cameron, I always looked up to Cameron when I was growing up. We went to the same Christian camp together. He was a counselor for me. I remember asking him questions about my faith from when I was like, probably like 13, 14 going on, like really intensely. I went to Cameron, asked him questions. He was always there for me. The religious guidance, the life guidance I got from him is insane, immeasurable. It's why I'm probably still a Christian today. But thanks. I remember we were on a Christmas cruise like my freshman year of college, so about 3 years ago, and I was talking to him, and I was like, hey, man, you know, we haven't talked in a minute. Is there any girl? He said, you know, one of my friends told me to check out this girl on Instagram. Like, we're going on a date in like a week or something. And I'm pretty sure they'd been going out for like a little bit before that. That was the first time I heard of Rachel. And then you started coming around and it was just awesome. You guys were clearly a perfect fit, like everyone else here has been saying. I'm so glad that you're part of the family. I love you. I'm so glad to have you around. I was crying before she even started walking down the aisle. I saw like that big white umbrella in the back. She hadn't even opened the door yet. I love you guys so much. Glad to be with you forever.
men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
She sways to whatever song plays without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here wearing the weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. She's pulling at me saying, Dad, I need you. There's a ball at the castle and I've been invited, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I'll dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. 'Cause I know something the prince never knew. She raises all last friends.
dream.